Today we are present at Muslim Youth University, Islamabad, and I am interviewing the Vice-Chancellor of Muslim Youth University, Professor Dr. Tahir Hijazi. Welcome, Professor.
Thank you.
Could you tell us a bit about yourself, where you grew up, what you studied, and your early life?
My schooling was in Lahore. My father was posted there, and after class 9th, my family shifted to Peshawar. That's my hometown. And I did my matric from public school and FSC from Edwards College, Peshawar, and BA also from Edwards College, Peshawar, which is my family college, because my father, my brother, my grandfather, everybody studied from that college. So it has got a tradition for our family. That's where actually I grew up. After my graduation, I came to Islamabad and Qaid-e-Azam University. And from there onwards, I was here and, you know, abroad and so on.
What do you remember of your own time as a university student?
Well, that's very interesting. My time of university was a very tough one, because I was in an economics department, Qaid-e-Azam University, and we have a bunch of young professors who were foreign qualified. They came from England, USA and so on. They were very ambitious to have a very good economics program, so they put us in a very tough situation. And I really admired them, and I really remember all of them, because they have sort of put a spark in ourselves to really exert, you know, in the worst scenario. So that was a very tough time, and university time was very good, and still we have memories and friends from that time. Even yesterday I got a friend who came to meet me after almost 30-40 years, and he was my fellow students in the university.
What career path you pursued before becoming the Vice-Chancellor?
Did my intermediate, my first aim was to go to the armed forces. And I was selected in Air Force as a general duty pilot. But medically I was declared not fit for that. So after that I decided to do economics. And my aim was at that time to do PhD, and so, you know, I did my bachelor and I did my master's from Pakistan. So I stayed as a, you know, economist, and I really loved that. And I started my career as a lecturer. I went through each step: assistant professor, associate professor, full professor, associate dean, dean, vice president, and vice chancellor. So it's like a complete track, you know, I followed that, yeah.
What do you think, which opportunities your university can create for the students to tackle the market after completing their degrees?
Right, that's a very important question, and I've been thinking for the last 18 years, 19 years, I've been in the academic leadership, you know, either dean or vice chancellor or vice president. So at every step, you know, we have been thinking about, you know, what to teach to students, you know, what should be the best education we can give them that could make them successful in the job market. Now what I see is, and we have been, you know, trying to develop their communication skills, you know, writing skills, and their visions, and how they can, you know, access to the opportunities and so on, you know. It's a student with a personality, you know. However, what I see in the last 3-4 years, there's a change in the whole trend of the market, and which everybody is realizing, but I mean it will take some time for the universities, all the universities, to adopt it. We are adopting it. The change is that the job market is shrinking, but there are, because technology is taking up. So either we have to produce graduates who should be on top of the technology, they should go at the back end to run the technology. I'll give you an example. The banking used to have absorb a lot many graduates. Now the banking is shrinking to become branchless banking, because you can cash your money at the teller machine, you can have your software, you know, account, internet account, and you can transfer the money from there. So you don't need to go to the bank. So the banks are becoming shrinking, and banks are trying to move from, you know, prime locations to, you know, upper in the flats and so on, you know, low cost area. Now this is going to affect the job market. Similarly, in everything, you know, there's a change. So either you have to be technology expert at the back end, or you should be an entrepreneur. So think about it, because technology has also given opened a window for all the students through laptop, you know, to get into the world market, so they can start their businesses in different ways. And there's so many thousands and thousands and millions of opportunities for new jobs, you know. So we are trying to focus on that so that the students should learn technology, how they can do that. One of the things which we really force our students to improve their typing speed so that they should be more efficient, and we are very happy the students are adopting that and they are becoming very good fast typers too.
How would you like to see your vice-chancellorship in the next decade?
You see, vice-chancellor is supposed to be nothing other than a leader. Vice-chancellor is not an accountant. Vice-chancellor is not an auditor. Vice-chancellor is not a clerk. Vice-chancellor is not an administrator. Vice-chancellor is supposed to provide the vision to the university. This is what I have learned over time working with the government as when the member of the planning commission, working with the university, is an American university in Dubai, working with Pakistani universities, working in USA as teaching, working in Greece as a teacher. You know, I have learned a lot, many things, you know, where I can inculcate the vision into the students and the faculty. That's what should be my role. That's what I think it should be the role of the vice chancellor. That's what I'm trying to do.
Any advice for your university students and for the youth in general?
My message for youth is very strong. If you work hard today, you will be able to relax the rest of the life. If you relax today, you will be in a tough situation all your life. So work hard now, learn things, you know, learn to do things, and you will have a perfect life to follow. That's what I really want my students to be.
Thank you, Professor, for giving us time. So this was the interview with the Vice Chancellor of Muslim Youth University, Islamabad. Your feedback is very important to us. You can write us your feedback through our social media pages and our webpage, that is universitytimes.pk. Thank you for watching the show. I'll be looking forward to see you all in the next episode. Till then, ciao.